Before we start our monthly update for July 2021, August is our aim for 8 months. Over August, we want to get you to the stage where you can pay your mortgage at 8% per annum. Throughout the month, we'll release tips on saving money and paying off your mortgage correctly. So make sure you check out our Facebook and Instagram page for those tips. All right, July 2021, and what a month. For the first time in a long, long time, mortgage interest rates increased, with ASB bravely stepping up first. The day before the OCR announcement, the bank increased their rates on average by about 0.35%. That took their cheapest one-year rate from 2.19% to 2.55%. The next day, the Reserve Bank announced that the OCR remained at 0.25%, and to celebrate, the other banks also raised their interest rates to match ASB. Now, while we're on the subject of the OCR, some economists are picking it to increase next month after being on hold at 0.25% for over 16 months. This is amazing, with forecasts of the OCR rise sitting at the end of 2022, more than a year and a half away, just 2 months ago, and articles on potentially negative interest rates just 4 or 5 months ago. Now, a rise of 0.35% to your mortgage means an additional $350 per year per $100,000 of mortgage. So some mortgages will see an increase of a couple of $1,000s per year. Hopefully not enough to tip a lot of people over, but if a rise of 0.35% has you concerned, now is very much the time to think about how you deal with your mortgage in the future. In other property news, Chloe Swarbrick from the Greens Party made brief headlines for suggesting the Healthy Home Standards, which came into effect on 1st of July, should be policed not by the tenants of a rental property, but by requiring landlords to get a warrant of fitness on their rental properties. While a minority of landlords simply balked at the added level of bureaucracy, the major complaint seemed to be the price point she mentioned. Her example cost of $150 every 3 years seemed to most to be too light, with many people pointing out that you couldn't get a builder to get out of their now heavily taxed Ford Ranger for $150, let alone check the insulation in the roof of your rental property. Finally, quarter two numbers released by CoreLogic show that the market is close to or at a turning point. The reasons seem to be the culmination of several changes to mortgage lending policies, including the reinstatement of loan-to-value ratios, bright line test changes, rental property tax deductibility changes, and finally, the threat of debt-to-income ratios. CoreLogic also noted that the number of valuations ordered by the banks, an early indicator of pre-approvals and therefore market sentiment, have eased, including a slowdown in buyer activity. However, they did note that the slowdown is more represented in investment buyers who, as previously mentioned, have been hit with higher deposit requirements and tax changes than in the first home buyer market. Good news at last for the first home buyers of New Zealand. So a busy July, increased interest rates, decreased housing enthusiasm, and underquoted warrant fitnesses. I'm Rupert Gough from the Mortgage Lab. Thank you for joining me.